Hello, let's talk about the subject no one ever wants to talk about, weighing and measuring and before and after pictures. So I'm going to tackle weighing yourself first. I personally don't mind if you don't want to weigh yourself. If you threw out your scale a long time ago, you do not have to go out and buy a scale. If you do currently weigh yourself, I'm fine if you continue to weigh yourself. But what I hope you will do is make a promise to me and to yourself that you will only weigh yourself once a week at the same time each week. So, for instance, pick Sunday morning, Monday morning, and only weigh yourself once a week. I know everyone gets eager and you want to see and know that you're making progress and that you're getting results. And I see people time and time again get on the scale one day and it's down. And then they get on the scale the next day and oh, it goes up a pound. And then they get on the scale the next day. You're just going to drive yourself crazy if you do that. Now, for me, a scale was a good thing because I didn't know that I had gained weight. I mean, of course I knew I'd gained weight because my clothes weren't fitting and I felt gross and everything, but I had no idea I had gained over 12 pounds. I thought I'd gained like 4 pounds. So when the doctor told me I'd gained 12, I did go out and buy a scale just so I could kind of keep up with it. I trust that you're an adult and you will make a good decision and not totally obsess over it. And just know that the way this program works, that, you know, your weight is just a number and is not a good way to tell if you are progressing. I would much rather you take measurements. I would much rather you pay attention to non-scale victories, things like pants fitting looser, rings being looser, having more energy, feeling better, things like that. So let's talk about measuring yourself. Now, measuring yourself, you just have to do it. Please, please, please do it. I showed you in the welcome video the little back of the brochure where you write all your measurements and it tells you what to measure. Please do that. Write it down and put it in the app so that you have it two places. I've just seen so many people who have either lost their written measurements or deleted the app and lost those. I just want to make sure that you have everything ready. So come day 21 or day 30, whatever the case may be, that you are ready and you have your measurements there. Be sure you go buy a tape measure. If you go to Target, they're right by the irons and the ironing boards. I can't tell you how many times I've gone into Target and I can't remember where they are. So that's where they are. And I think most places like Walmart, they also keep them kind of, there's like a sewing section, like sewing emergency kits and stuff like that in with the irons and ironing boards. So go ahead and get your tape measure. I know this is not what you want to do after the holidays, but you really, really need to do it. Your body will change. You will see inches. You will see that you lose inches. You will lose pounds, especially the more consistent you are. Every now and then I've had challengers who haven't lost any pounds, but their body has totally changed and they've lost inches. So again, when you start to figure out how to eat properly and how much to eat and you're exercising, especially if this is new for you, your body really is going to change. So again, that's why you take the measurements. Before pictures, I really, 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 really hope you will also take before pictures for a number of reasons. First of all, it could be costing you $100,000 if you don't take your before pictures. Beachbody has a contest where you can enter your before and after pictures every time you complete a program. You get a free t-shirt just for entering. And then they give away daily prizes, $500 to male and female winners every day. And then I think there's a $1,000 weekly prize, maybe $5,000 monthly prize, and then there's a quarterly prize. Then they have semifinalists, and then the top male gets $100,000. The top female gets $100,000. So again, if you're not taking before pictures, you're cheating yourself out of potentially winning that money. And I really hope y'all do enter. There's so many of you who have such inspiring transformations that you could totally inspire others just by doing that. And you could also potentially win $500 to $100,000. So there's another brochure that comes in your challenge pack that tells you how to take before and after pictures. It's great to do it in, you know, a jog bra and shorts, in a bathing suit or something like that. Again, your body will change, and sometimes you just won't even believe it until you actually see it in pictures. I know you don't want to take pictures. I get it. Take the pictures. Password protect them somewhere in a file on your computer or your phone. I've had people rig it up so that they are looking in the bathroom mirror and standing on a stool, and they're able to take their own pictures. So nowadays, you totally can take a selfie before picture pretty easily. And again, I hope you will. I think if my challengers who have been with me for a while could chime in on this post and tell us whether or not you took before and after pictures, and whether or not you took your measurements, and whether or not you regret not taking pictures and not doing measurements. Nobody wants to do it, and then everybody regrets after the fact that they didn't do it. So reach out to me if you have any concerns about it. You don't ever have to share any of it with anyone whatsoever. It's mainly for you so you can see how you've progressed. So I hope this video helps. So now stop watching it, go buy a tape measure, and get ready to have a starting point so that you know how far you will have gone either in a month, or I hope you'll stay with me for the whole year. Thanks, guys.